Hello children, today we are going to take our new topic, that is whole number. What are whole numbers and how we are going to work on whole numbers, we will be seeing in this chapter. Introduction. Numbers play an important role in our life. We use numbers in our day-to-day life to count things. While counting, we use numbers to represent any quantity, to measure any distance or length. For example, the picture what I have taken, if you observe, here you can see four different type of pictures. In that, you will be seeing the basket of fruits, next the discount sale, and next one is the distance between two places, and the last is the table. When you observe the first picture, in that picture, you are going to identify the fruits. Now, how you are going to count the fruits in that? You will be counting that there are three apples and three pears in the basket. Now, if you are going to see the discount mark on the picture, how we are going to tell it is 50% discount? Whenever you are taking any product to our home, we will be checking the discount system. So in that you will be checking the discount of the quantity. Next, if you observe, it is the distance between two places. When you are seeing the distance between two places, you will be finding the length of the distance. So here the distance between two cities is 220 kilometers, largest distance, not the smaller length. It is the largest distance. The next last one is the table. If you observe here also you will be checking the point starting and the point last, that is the length, that is also a distance, but the smaller distance is known as length. For the table, we will be calculating only length. Now, the counting numbers starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are termed as natural numbers. Natural numbers starts from 1 and there is no end to the numbers. Those numbers are called natural numbers. The set of counting numbers and 0. If we are counting numbers along with 0, such type of numbers are known as whole numbers. Whole numbers are starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. We don't have any end of the numbers. Now we will see how whole numbers on a number line is represented. Now first we have to understand what is meant by number line. So number line is nothing but a pictorial representation of numbers evenly marked on a straight line is known as number line. Number line is nothing but a pictorial representation of numbers on a straight line. To mark whole numbers on a number line, draw a horizontal line and mark a point on it as 0. Extended this line towards right direction. Starting from 0, mark points 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on a line at equal distance towards right side. Whatever I told, see here, we are drawing a straight line as it is in the picture, and starting with a line horizontally, mark it as 0, and rest is followed with the picture what you are seeing here. This is how we are going to form our number line. Now, there is no whole number on the left of 0. Therefore, 0 is the smallest whole number. If you observe the picture, we are not having any number left of this. We are having only the numbers on the right side. So, 0 is the smallest whole number. A whole number is greater than all the whole numbers which lie to the left of it on the number line. If you observe, 0 is having a greater number, that is 1. For 1, if we are having one more greater number, 2. So, we will be having only the greater numbers followed in the number line. A whole number is less than all the whole numbers which lie on the right of it on the number line. If we are moving towards the right, we will be having our greater values. And when we are moving backward, we are getting our smaller values. So, whole numbers are having greater values and smaller values on the number line. The number line also helps us to compare two whole numbers, that is to decide which are the two digits give whole numbers are equal or greater or smaller. From the above number line, we can say that 5 is less than 9 and write 5 less than 9. We can also say that 5 is greater than 4. If you observe the picture here, see here, what I have taken the statement first, 5 is less than 9 because 5 is coming first and 9 is coming last. So, 9 is the larger number for 5. So, I have taken 5 is smaller than 9. And seeing the next one, 5 is greater than 4. If you observe the picture, 5 is written after 4, that's why 4 is less than 5. So 5 is greater than 4. Operation on a number line means how to do addition, subtraction, multiplication or division, whatever it is. Operation means we are having 4 mathematical operations. Those are addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So we will be seeing what are the operations we can do on the number line. First one is addition. Now I have taken 2 digits. Those are 2 and 5. Now I have to add this both on the number line. So what is our first step? Start from 0. 2 jumps towards right, you reach it 2, means starting number is our 0, because all the number line starts with 0. So we have to jump 2 times forward. If we are jumping 2 times forward, we will be reaching our number 2. Next, what is the number I have taken? 5. So you have to take 5 jumps towards right to reach the addition number. So when you are jumping 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, you will be reaching your number 7. So 2 plus 5 is equal to nothing but our product, it is 7. We have seen how to do addition on the number line. We will go our next topic, that is subtraction. How to do subtraction on the number line? So for that I have taken 2 numbers here, that is 4 from 7. Means we have to subtract 7 minus 4. We have to take the larger number first and the smaller number next. Start from 0, jump directly to 7. What is the statement here? You are starting from 0 because it is the smallest number on the whole number line. So you have to jump directly towards 7. You have reached here 7. Now start from 7, 4 jumps towards left. Till now we are moving right side. Now what we have to do? We have to come left side. Left side means you have to come backwards. So 4 jumps towards left, you reach it 3. From 7, if you are coming 4 times back, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have reached the number 3. So your difference from 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. This is how you are going to do the subtraction on the number line. Now we will see multiplication on number line. For multiplying a multiplication on number line, how we are going to do, we will see. I have taken an example, that is 3 into 2. Multiplication means, as you all know, it is a repeated addition. Since 3 into 2 means 3 should be added twice. 3 should be added twice. For example, 3 plus 3. Whatever the example I have taken, it is 3. So I have to add 3 for 2 times. That we will be getting our answer 6. Why I am adding only 3 for 2 times? Because the question is 3 into 2. So 3 into 2 is equal to nothing but our same answer is 6. So what you have to do? How you are going to jump on the number line? Start from 0. Make 2 jumps. Each jump of 3 units. You have to jump each time 3 units. So how many jumps you have to take? You have to take 2 jumps. Start from 0, for 3 units 1 jump, and for 3 units 2nd jump. So when you are jumping 3 units for 2 times, what you will be reaching? You will be reaching for 6. Your answer is 6. This is how you are going to do the multiplication on the number line. Till now we have seen how to add, subtract and multiply on number line. Now we will be seeing the properties of addition. In properties of addition, the first one is closure property. What is that? Closure property. For any two whole numbers A and B, their sum A plus B is always a whole number. What are whole numbers? Any number you take from 0 to any of the number, you are not having any end of the number. So any number, that is starting from 0, if you are taking any number, and when you are adding both the whole numbers, you will be getting answer also whole number. For example, I have taken here my number is 12, that is A, and 45 is my number B. Now what I am doing, I am adding both the numbers. When I am adding both the numbers, I got my answer 57. 57 is what? 57 is my whole number. 57 is my whole number. So when you are adding both whole numbers, you are getting answer is also a whole number. Now 12, 45 and 57 are all whole numbers. This is the property what we are using here. A and B are both two whole numbers. A plus B is equal to the same whole number. Now we are going to see the next property, that is commutative property. commutative property. For any two whole numbers a and b, a plus b is equal to b plus a. We can add any two whole numbers in any order. If you see here, a plus b and b plus a, here I have changed the order. Here I have written a first, and when coming to the next one I have written b first. Even if you change the order of the whole numbers, the answer what you are going to get, it will be the same. For example, if you see here, same numbers I have taken. A is equal to 12, B is equal to 45. So here I am writing the numbers in reverse order. B is equal to 45, A is equal to 12. When I am going to add both the numbers, I will be getting the same answer, that is 57. 57 will be my answer on both the sides. This is called commutative property. A plus B is equal to B plus A. Now we will see the next property, that is associative property. Associative property. For any three whole numbers a, b and c, a plus b plus c is equal to a plus b plus c. Here what we have done, here we are taking a plus b in the brackets first, and when you are coming after equal to, you will be taking numbers b plus c in the bracket. This means the sum is regardless of how grouping is done. We are going to group the numbers differently, but we are getting the answer as same. Here I have taken my number A as 31, B 24, C 38. That is equal to, I have taken A, B, C again here. If you observe, A is separate and B plus C are together in the brackets. And when you are coming to the equal to, after equal to symbol, A plus B are grouped in one side and plus 38 is written A side. When you are doing like that, first you have to add the numbers in the brackets. When you are adding numbers in the brackets, what you are going to get the answer? 24 plus 38. 24 plus 38 is nothing but our, what is the answer, Nana? It is 62. Now add 62 plus 31. 62 plus 31 is nothing but your 93. If you add, that is equal to, now you group the numbers here, 31 plus 24. So what will be your answer here? It is 55. 55. Now 55 plus 38. 55 plus 38. Now you add both the numbers here, you will be getting your answer 93. Now the product what you are getting, those both are equal. So A plus B plus C in brackets is equal to A plus B in brackets plus C. Whatever it is the order, the product will be the same. This is called your associative property. Now next one is additive property. What is that? Additive property. For every whole number, A plus 0 is equal to A. Therefore, 0 is called the additive identity. For any whole number, any number you take, for that, if you are adding 0, you will be getting the same number. So, 0 is called the additive identity of the numbers. Till now we have seen the properties of addition. Now we are going to check the properties of subtraction. In subtraction, the properties will not be equal as addition, because whole numbers means we will be getting only positive numbers. We will not get our negative numbers. If we are going to the closure property in subtraction, you can check the difference here. For any two whole numbers A and B, if A is greater than B, then A minus B is a whole number. And if A is less than B, then A minus B is never a whole number. Closure property is not always applicable to subtraction. If you check the example here, 150 minus 100. That is A minus B. When you are doing A minus B, you are getting a number, positive number, that is 50. 50 is a whole number. But when you are taking A as 100 and B as 150, when you are doing subtraction in both the numbers, you are going to get a negative number. If you are getting a negative number, it is not a whole number. Always whole numbers are starting from only 0. We will not have any negative numbers. So closure property is not applicable in subtraction. Now we will see the next one, that is commutative property. For any two whole numbers A and B, A minus B is not equal to B minus A. Hence subtraction of whole numbers is not commutative. Here also it is not commutative. It is the statement A minus B is not equal to B minus A. If for example 16 minus 7, if you take it is 9, but where you will take 7 minus 16, it is not equal to a whole number, that is 9. So this statement is that A minus B is not equal to B minus A. We'll see our next property, that is associative property. For any three whole numbers A, B, C, A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C. If you observe the statement here, A minus B is taken in the group here in the form of brackets, and B minus C also is taken in a group here. Now what we have to do when you are applying this in any number form, if you have taken any example and you are applying that numbers in this statement, how you have to solve that? For example, I have taken here A is equal to 25, B is equal to 10, C is equal to 4. Now what I am going to do, I am going to apply, first I will take brackets of B minus C. So A I have written as it is 25 minus, what is my B here, 10, what is my C here, 4. So I have applied that in the brackets. Now what I have to do, I have to write this 25 as it is here and check out 10 minus 4 is 6. So one negative number with one positive number in the bracket will be always a negative number. So 25 minus 6 is equal to 19. So next I am going to take A minus B as my next group. So A minus B, what is my A here? 25. What is my B here? 10. Now 25 minus 10, how much I am going to get? I am going to get 15 here. After bracket, whatever the symbol is there, you write directly that symbol, that is minus 4. 15 minus 4 is equal to 11. Now if you see here, 25 minus 10 minus 4 is not equal to 25 minus 10 minus 4. That means A minus, take the bracket, B minus C, close the bracket, is not equal to A minus B, put in the brackets, minus C, is not equal. These both are not equal. This is how we are going to check our associative property. These both will be not equal. Where in the case of addition, both will be equal, but in the case of subtraction, these will be not equal to each other in any property. Children, it's your turn now. Learn the following and frame your own example basing on the formulas. Properties of addition. What is closure property? A plus B. Commutative property, A plus B is equal to B plus A. Associative property, A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. But the putting of brackets is different in this case. Observe it and learn. Next one is additive identity property. A plus 0 is equal to A. Any whole number added with 0 will be getting the whole number. This is how you have to learn and practice by taking your own examples, only whole numbers, that is positive numbers. Properties of subtraction. Closure property. When A is greater than B, then A minus B is equal to a whole number. If A is less than B, then A minus B will not be a whole number. If you are taking A as 14, 14 can be subtracted from the smaller numbers of 14, then it will be a whole number. If A is for 25 and B is 35, then A is a smaller number, B is a greater value. You can't subtract that because you will be getting a negative answer. That's why A is greater than B, then A minus B will be your whole number. If A is lesser than B, it will be not equal to a whole number. Next, commutative property. A minus B is not equal to B minus A. Associative property. A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C. Here, grouping of numbers is different. A minus B is grouped in ones, and in the other side, it is B minus C. Read the properties carefully, understand them, and practice your own sums only by taking the positive whole numbers. Hari Om, thank you. If you have any doubts, you can get back to me.